how many of our members do we have their voting sheets for?
We have everyone except for... Oh, we have all of them.
All right, and we have present Senator Kaplan and Senator Felder, and thank you for coming. We have five bills on today. Four bills on today, so it's a quick meeting. And thank you, Senator Felder, you've got your plenty of time. I just want to thank, you know, there was a very major tragedy this past week. An 8-year-old was killed by a parent. And so we have here to talk to us from Suffolk County, Mr. Levler and Mr. Heumann. They are with an organization, which is AME. So they're not really talking to us today, but we look forward to working with them. They have come to help us try to figure out what we might begin to think about in terms of addressing before a child is unfortunately dies at the hands of a parent, any adult, what can we do as a, I think, early intervention program. So I want to thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.
It's a long way to travel. We appreciate you so much. And they're also represented by Gordon Warnock.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Who is, and please make sure you be nice to him. Because he's with the state troopers, too. He's a state trooper.
I've been in the Senate for 30 years.
So we always give them due respect and regard. But he's here really representing to support the AME today. So we will begin with our schedule, our bills.
Okay, the first bill is 1086B by Senator Prasad, an act to amend the social services law in relation to allowances for the cost of diapers.
Can we
move the bill?
Move the bill. All in favor? Any no votes? Do you have any questionable votes? And as you know, Senator Prasad tried this last year, and I think she's sort of answered some of the questions that people had about it. And we're moving the bill today. Second? Can we get a second? Second. It's been moved and seconded. Any further discussion? Okay.
The second bill
is reported.
The second bill is 4004 from Senator Carlucci, an act to amend the social services law in relation to requiring agencies to provide potential adoptive parents with information concerning state-funded benefits or services received by a foster child that expire upon adoption.
Move to bill.
Motion. Second. Any discussion? Thank you. The bill is reported out.
Third bill is S-5493, Senator Montgomery, an act to amend the social services law in relation to limiting co-payments for child care subsidies.
Move the bill.
Thank you. Any discussion on the bill? Any questions? Okay, I have a chart in case you want to see the disparity in your own area of how much parents have to pay in co-payments.
I would love to have a copy of that.
Okay, we will share that with you. It comes from the Empire Justice Center. They worked on this. This has been a problem for many, many years. And so I think the range is between 10 and 35%. So it goes pretty, pretty high for as a co-payment cost, which depending on what the co-payment is, the cost of childcare goes up astronomically for parents.
And this is being referred to finance.
It's being referred to finance. It has to have. So we would have to try to estimate what
the
percent
impact
this is going to come back on us to pay for. But nonetheless, we think it's very, very important for us to do that. So I thank you. The bill is reported.
Okay, the last bill, S-6533, Senator Montgomery, an act to amend the Family Court Act in relation to video recording of interrogations of juveniles in juvenile delinquency proceedings in family court.
Move the bill.
It's been moved and seconded by Senator Felder. I just want to just say briefly that we all remember the Central Park 5 situation, and we don't have coverage in the family court proceeding for juveniles.
Yes.
That would be, welcome Senator Prasad, that would be comparable to what we've done with criminal court. So this is tying up another loose end related to raise the age, so that this would require the juveniles in be that we look
able
at
to tape them.
Videotaping them from the very beginning of the interrogation process. So that would be. So
we're done almost.
I know.
So that's what this is. Also.
Yes.
So thank you, and the bill will be reported.
Oh my gosh!
Thank you.
And thank you, members. Is there anybody want to ask any questions of the gentleman from AME?
If there's anything you'd like to share with us, you've come all this way and you want to have, obviously it's unfortunate under the circumstances that you're here, but we thank you for your advocacy and trying to find solutions. It is really gut-wrenching to hear the story and what happened to this little boy.
So I guess if I could share anything at all, it's that, you know, this was a great tragedy. It's something that we believe is preventable. And we have to seek to work together, obviously lawmakers, with the public as well, and everyone actually doing this job to try and find solutions to ensure in the state of New York this never happens again. So we look forward to speaking to you all in the future with some suggestions as to what we think could possibly help.
Thank you.
I think we'll work directly with Senator Montgomery's office. We've come up with a range of solutions. It's kind of a little quick. We want to make sure they're vetted through our own internals, and then we'll be back.
And, you know, we don't have a crisis intervention mechanism where people who are in crisis can be identified early through some means. I just recall seeing something in Philadelphia. Where they had a system that identified a crisis based on absenteeism of a child, so that if that child was absent X number of times, it would automatically trigger this crisis intervention going into place. And it was connected with a court system, with law enforcement, in case there was a situation with domestic violence or whatever might be happening. And so we don't have anything like that yet, but it's
nice
something that we need to begin to talk about.
Yes.
Instituting as a mechanism to hopefully prevent this kind of thing happening. Because apparently it didn't just happen instantly. It was over time.
And the Maureen Brown's case and all of that. Yes. And we say it all
and
over again.
Exactly.
And
it was in my district that one of these situations happened.
And, you know, we're constantly saying never again and then...
Keeps happening.
Yes, so this is really, I think, you know, a call for us to go ahead and start thinking seriously about creating some mechanism so that those families, in particular, that are in crisis, we can identify them earlier before our child is killed.
So. Thank you so much for the committee's
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.